So I am here today with Chris from ShinyLoot. Chris, how are you doing today?
I am doing well.
That's
Thank
good.
You very much. How are you doing?
I'd be doing better if the first few takes of this had gone well, but that's what technology likes to do to you sometimes. But
well, we've practiced at least.
Yeah, yeah. So we should have this down, and this should be very witty and entertaining at this point.
Absolutely.
So so ShinyLoot has been running the Patrick Scott Patterson Indie Bundle, a really cool name. We work together on getting the game line up. How do you think it's been going so far?
It's been going well. I mean, our reception to the games that are in the bundle have been very positive. I mean, people like to see kind of the mix of games that we've brought on. There's a little bit of strategy, a little bit of adventure, a little bit of action. So, you know, it's kind of a crowd pleaser. And the games featured individually, I'm seeing positive feedback on. Ring Runner and Survivor Squad are two games that have been, you know, out on Steam somewhat recently, I think in the past year or so. And they've been really well received by kind of big action fans. Three Stars of Destiny is a game that probably came out about a month ago on Steam, and it's by Alderlea Games, who have done a great job of putting out a series of kind of retro style RPGs that have just tons of hours of playability. And then there's Space Kim, which is one of the first kind of big indie hit games that came out, and you know, people still love to just give positive feedback on it and encourage other people to buy the game. And then the other two are greenlit, Dwarf Quest and Residue. So they'll be out on Steam pretty soon. And, you know, again, they're just these games that kind of bring something a little bit different to the table. Residue has a kind of cool adventure story with some character switching going on. And Dwarf Quest is a good kind of strategy RPG. You know, as it sounds, you're a dwarf on a quest kind of going through a dungeon crawl, and it's a great game as well.
So, I'm glad that we were able to work together, actually. It was a team effort.
We talked over a few games. I sent over some kind of big list of suggestions, and then you, Scott, were good about picking out kind of a good mix of games that, you know, really embodied the kind of games that you wanted to see as part of the bundle, and it ended up being a really good mix of games.
Well, you know, I definitely wanted a good mix because that's what video gaming is. You know, I mean, it's there's a lot of great games out there, a lot of great genres, and you know, hopefully maybe a fan of one genre that might have picked up the bundle thanks to the deal might have discovered something that they would have liked or that they like that they might not have picked up otherwise, and that's a good thing. That's a good thing for everybody.
Yeah, no, I think it's really good. I mean, most gamers have got a little bit of interest in, you know, at least a few of the different areas and genres that are out there. And there's a little bit of, genre bending in this bundle as well. You've got some with a little bit of action and RPG, some a little bit of strategy and RPG, and they touch on a little bit of different areas. And so I think people that maybe are only initially interested in one or two games in the bundle will find themselves actually liking a few more of the games as well.
Now, there are, of course, you know, indie game genre has exploded, and it seems like every single day you're hearing about new games and new studios popping up, and so it's kind of a crowded marketplace, and there's quite a few places that you can go to pick and choose and search for your latest indie discovery. In your eyes, yeah, I know you're going to be partial here, of course, a little bit, but why should people choose to go to ShinyLoot for their indie gaming needs?
So one of the reasons is because we do a good job of distributing not only Steam keys, but Steam keys with DRM-free and DRM-lite versions of games. So DRM-lite being games that have a one-time key validation. So basically, when you buy a game from ShinyLoot, you're not only getting the convenience of having a game on Steam, but you're also getting that safety and peace of mind that you'll have that DRM-free version forever to play whenever you want from ShinyLoot. And in addition, we do a lot to make exploration and discovery of new indie games kind of the forefront.
Indie games, there's so many coming out. I mean, I don't even think anybody could really sit there and list to you every indie game that's becoming available out there. Some do well, some don't. Some bad games do well, and some really good games don't. What do you think the biggest obstacle and the biggest challenge for somebody getting into the indie marketplace is, and how do you think ShinyLoot might be able to help them out with getting out there, getting seen?
So, I mean, like a lot of things, it's just about exposure. If you've got a really quality game, sometimes you just really need to get enough exposure out there to kind of hit that critical mass before you can really kind of start exploding in growth. And there's tools out there through, you know, other services like Steam's Greenlight, which are helping to kind of facilitate that. I mean, they do a good job of getting indie games on the storefront alongside these other AAA releases. But there's still these kind of indie games that kind of fall by the wayside or take a while to kind of get to where they're going. And ShinyLoot and other ventures and distributors out there really kind of help move that along by just getting another crowd of people out there. And so ShinyLoot was kind of formed as a somewhat unique take on the stores in that we don't really do a lot with AAA titles. We're really focused primarily on indie titles and getting those well known, especially through our discovery exploration system, which basically distills games down into traits or individual game features so that people can kind of find the games that they're most interested in without just doing a big Google search and hoping they find, you know, the game that they want to play.
All right. Well, before we wrap this up, I'm actually going to put you on the spot. A couple of questions.
Okay.
All right, this is live and unrehearsed, folks, so I don't know what he's going to say, and I don't think he knows what I'm going to ask. So we'll start with the softer one. What do you think is the most underrated indie title out there right now?
It's hard to not answer that with a biased or an unbiased answer. Part of it being because I'm friends with the guys at Zeboid Games. So I love Cthulhu Saves the World. I think that's a title that has gotten some good mention in the indie community. It's an older game, but it's a mix of humor, the kind of cool skill system you get when you level up, where you get to kind of choose how you want to advance your character, is just kind of a blast to play through. And it's $2.99. It's a good price. Just kind of packs a lot of punch for the price that you pay. One that I'm going to say that's probably if I'm going to give an unbiased answer, I really like Atom Zombie Smasher. And it's kind of a fun little game you can play for 30 minutes at a whack. Mixes strategy with action and kind of franticness all in one package. And it's another enjoyable one as well.
All right. Well, the second one, a little more hardball. And if you want to plead the fifth, I certainly don't blame you. But I have to know, what do you think would probably be the most overrated indie title that went out there? Meaning, you know, something that got wildly successful and you have absolutely no idea why.
Huh. That's a good question. I definitely would have an answer for it if I thought about it. What is one that I've played? You know what? It's probably something I own. And I was like, why did I buy this? It doesn't make sense.
To be honest, I thought you might actually give you the easy answer. I think everybody kind of thought Flappy Bird with that one. So, you know, I know that it was more, you know, on the phone and all that. But I know a lot of people are like, why is this game popular?
Oh, I don't even really think of that in the same category, I guess. That's why. Yeah, I mean, you know, you could say Flappy Bird. It's not really new or interesting at all. I mean, you press a button over and over. I mean, these things have been done before. So yeah, I guess that's maybe so far out of my realm of what I even consider indie game, just because of the perspective of what I deal with, trying to look for really unique games, that something like that is almost off the radar. I mean, you know, I think any of the Zynga games are certainly in that same realm of kind of rehashing things that have been done by other actual developers as well.
All right.
Yeah. No.
No worries. No.
Yeah. Flappy Bird's not, I guess, and those kind of games typically aren't critically acclaimed. So I was kind of racking my brain for a surprising answer to give you.
Okay. All right. One more, and then we'll wrap it up here. I mean, like I said, indie games have been exploding for the last several years, and sometimes I see a lot of similarities to it than in the history of the film industry, whereas the film industry grew and grew and grew and became big budget, big studio. You started having room underneath for smaller studios to come along and make little independent films. And over time, you kind of had multiple layers of films. What do you see in terms of indie games? What the future of indie gaming is, and do you think it'll follow like a similar pattern?
I think so. I mean, we're already seeing indie games just starting to become more prominent in the public eye. People are getting excited about studios that have put out games before, you know, that they're starting to follow and really get attached to. And those are kind of spreading from just their initial circle of customers to friends of those customers, and they're getting talked about more. And so I think that we're going to see indie games really take over a certain subset of gaming. I mean, there's still the games that, let's say MMOs, for instance, that are just always going to be dominated by AAA studios. I mean, they're just way too expensive to produce. But, you know, with the RPGs and games that are not necessarily as engine intensive and graphic intensive, indie games can become kind of the norm. And so I think we'll just continue to see those grow as people realize that good quality titles do come from studios that are manned by, you know, one person, two people, 10 people. And so just it's one of those things that takes time for any sort of change to occur. And the product is good, and I think people will realize that more as time goes by.
Cool, man. That's a good answer. I think you've answered that one before, it sounds like. So,
oh, probably. You know, it's obviously something I'm passionate about and something I definitely believe in. And otherwise, I wouldn't have started ShinyLoot.
Yeah, well, that's always a good thing, Moore. If anything, passion is good in anything. And I think definitely is something that's needed in the video game space. A space that sometimes gets awfully cynical. And so, you know, nice positive passion. It's refreshing, man. And it's appreciated as well. So I appreciate everyone who listened in on this. If this is before May 11th, please go to ShinyLoot.com and buy the Patrick Scott Patterson Indie Bundle. I would sure like it and appreciate it if you did. There's a lot of good stuff in there, and Chris said so himself. If it's after that date, and the odds are that it probably will be, by all means, you know, still go to ShinyLoot.com and check out their bundles, check out their deals. And Chris, appreciate you taking the time today, and keep up the good work, man. Give me your close out with your best plug you can do.
ShinyLoot is a great store if you want to find new indie games and discover games that you didn't know existed that are perfectly suited for you. So come to our store, find a new game. Download it, play it, buy it, and praise the indie developers who made it.
That would be hard to fit into a jingle, man.
I like it, you know, that like 10-second, 15-second into the commercial type of spiel. I can give you a good jingle maybe later.
Maybe another time. Maybe the next time we chat, man. Hey, Chris, appreciate you, man. Just keep it up.
Yeah, thanks a lot. It's been good working with you on this bundle.
All right, man.